officials, agents, and in some cases, with the connivance of some local public and civil servants who are supposed to be apolitical in all their activities. We would wish to draw the attention of Ghanaians back to a few months ago. We aggressively criticized the president and his government on his unpardonable delay in nominating MMDCAs 8 months into office. This criticism was overwhelmingly endorsed and supported by civil society and local government practitioners who agreed that the delay was impeding the needed development at the local level. We must say that the president, after the persistent calls from Ghanaians, said on his miserable tour in the Western North region that the delay in nominating MFDCs was to afford a wider consultation with chiefs and all stakeholders before the names were released. After 9 months in office, the names were released, with almost 60% being renominations. So we ask the question, why the delay? If the president in his second term in office had to use almost 8 months to assess, evaluate, engage the performance of his MMDCs who have worked with him for 4 years, then we can easily ask the question, where are the men in this government? If the president has indeed consulted widely, as he said, then why are his nominees being rejected? Is it a case of disappointment in the president himself, or a case of the president's own people not ready to listen to him anymore? It is mind-boggling that some of these prominent rejections have been from the president's own political stronghold of the Ashanti region after the so-called wider consultation. Ladies and gentlemen of the media, we are not worried by these rejections because we are convinced that the government of Nado and Bawumia have been rejected by Ghanaians already in the 2020 elections by power through machinations. We are, however, awed by the abuse of the processes and procedures in the approval of the nominees as witnessed in some MMDCs. For purposes of clarity, we would mention a few. Ghanaians should be concerned with what happened in Asin South, Bibiani Anyanso Bekwa, Kapa Nsoayem, Swaman, Ewutu Senya West, Cape Coast Municipal, Sechekumewu, and other places. Especially this, just this morning, we have been informed of a horrible incident in Duaboso. I would like to take them one by one. Asin South. In the Asin South District Assembly, the MPP regional chairman is alleged to have used intimidation, coercion, and assault on assembly members perceived to be against the nominee. It was shameful how the regional chairman of MPP is led to have used about 30 fully armed men with about 22 in police uniform and the rest in mufti to prevent honorable assembly members from entering the hall where the second voting for the nominee was taking place. Two of the 15 assembly members who were prevented, Honorable Robert Tete for Awuro Camp and William Apia for Asin Ando, were heavily assaulted by the security personnel in the presence of the regional, divisional, and district police commanders. Their lives are also being threatened, and that's forcing them not to leave their respective homes. They are now being taken to court for daring to curse people who denied them their rights as assembly members. Bibiani Anyanso, the abuse of the process and procedure for the approval of the president nominee was given a comic but dangerous verse in the Bibiani Anyanso Bekwai district in the Western North region. In the widely reported incident, the regional minister, the nominee, and the coordinating director used crooked, unscrupulous, and undeclared deception to prevent as many as 33 members of the assembly from voting. Disgracefully and shamelessly, these people connived with the EC, changed the venue, time, and day of the proposed second voting, and only got 19 out of the 52 members of assembly to vote on the Sunday, 10th October 2021. Such despicable and antiquated act cannot be accepted in this day and age in our democratic Ghana. It's an insult, dent, and a repugnant smell on our democratic credentials as a nation, and this must be condemned by all well-meaning Ghanaians. Another abhorrent behavior of the use of security personnel, intimidation, coercion, and brutal force was displayed on Friday, 15th October 2021, as seen in a video in circulation to prevent the sitting member of parliament, Honorable Basua, and some assembly members from entering the hall of the meeting to vote on the president's nominee, who failed in two earlier attempts to secure the required vote. He was renominated by the president, perhaps. He is the only qualified, intelligent, and competent person in the whole district fit for the president's agenda. Instead of using legitimate and expected lobbying and compelling negotiations to secure the vote, a rather brute force, irresponsible use of machoism, and intimidation was deployed to get a botched approval. Swaman and Ewutu Senya West. Cases of shameful replacement of government appointees at the 11th hour to secure the approval were received in these two instances. A clear case of muzzling and coercion. Victimization of appointed members of the assembly for expressing their opinion in a free atmosphere. This is typical of the Nana Addo Dankwa government, the pervasive culture of silence. Shama. What makes the Shama case more disturbing is that there was an impending court injunction on the process, but the government and its agents disrespected the court, you know, as they did in Kumasi, and went ahead to organize the botched approval. Cape Coast. The story of the Cape Coast Municipal Assembly has received wide coverage and discussion already, and will not want to overflow it. But suffice to say that it was another disgraceful orchestration of the government to manipulate two fair or foul means to fester the president's nominee on the responsible assembly members who have twice rejected him, just as the people of Cape Coast South rejected him in the parliamentary elections in 2020. One would ask, why is the president Akufo-Addo so adamant and insistent on the rejected nominee, who after 4 years as MCE, contested as a parliamentary candidate and was rejected? He was renominated by the president for a second stint as MCE, and the assembly members twice voted against him. Why is the president being intransigent in this seeming litigation with the people of Okwa in trying to force an SAFA on them? Is he the only qualified person in the president's party in the Cape Coast municipality? Is the president telling the rest of his party people in the region they are useless and not competent enough to represent him in Okwa? Laura. The case of Laura is similar to that in Cape Coast, and we'll ask the same questions. However, in Laura, as we await the second nomination or renomination, we are cautioning the police to avoid any action that will infringe on the privileges of the assembly members and the EC to stop being used for such abominable act. We ask that assembly members are allowed to express their rights in free and fair atmosphere. Ladies and gentlemen, let me borrow the president's fellow Ghanaians. Kapa and Swayem is another disgraceful act of trampling upon the tenets and basic rules of our democracy by this power-drunk government. You all recount the unfortunate acts of assault, brutalities, and forceful eviction from the assembly hall that characterized the approval of the president's nominee in Takwa last year in May. The honorable assembly members who were unfortunately and despicably assaulted and physically prevented from entering the assembly hall to vote in that disgraceful incident went to court to seek justice, but were denied as expected under this dispensation. Today, upon the renomination of the same DCE, the assemblymen are being told a weird story that because the DCE was only nominated and approved last year, there won't be any approval this year. If the president, who is the lawyer, knew that the said DCE was only nominated and approved last year, why then did he renominate him? This failed attempt to get a DCE go back to office without the approval of the 2/3 members of the assembly present and voting as the law says would be resisted. Other noted incidents across the country are being monitored and would be critically analyzed and responded to. And just as I told you, we just had information that in Gaboso, from our MP and the presiding member, I've talked to him this morning. Whilst they were waiting for the renomination letter of the president or the wireless message, they heard that 9 people were marshaled into the residence of the DCE without the knowledge of the presiding member, who by law has the right to invite people to such a special meeting. Somebody was chosen as presiding member, and approval has been done
by 9
people in Jabusu. If it is not drama, then I don't know. After the 15 people. We in the NDC have a very deep appreciation of our local governance system and believe in it being the catalyst for the overall development of the country. We will therefore do all we can to protect the respect and the dignity of our local governance system from cunning usurpers of the dominant role it is supposed to play in our national development agenda. We shall protect the sanctity of our democracy and condemn in no uncertain terms actions of people who we see as wolves in sheep's clothing. Today in Ghana, we are people who are worse than the despots and dictators who have strewn the geopolitical sins of the world, but hiding under the clothes of Ghana's democratic credentials and slowly eating away the marrow in the spine of our democracy. We are therefore calling on the President and the Minister for Local Government, Rural Development and Decentralization to immediately A, order a rerun of all the disgraceful processes in the Bibiani and Nyanso Bekwai, Asin South, Sechile Kumewu, Cape Coast, and others, where the processes were manipulated to prevent known assembly members from exercising their constitutional mandate. We are asking the president to respect the will of the people and stop imposing all those nominees who have been twice rejected by the assembly members, as in Cape Coast, Laura, and others. We are calling on the IGP to cause an investigation into all those reported cases of the abuse of the processes, assault, intimidation, threats, and fiscal manhandling of assembly members and MPs in those MMDAs reported, and take disciplinary actions to prevent further deterioration of the confidence of the people in our security agencies and erase the impression of our men in uniform being used as tools for oppression and subjugation. We are also asking the IGP to explain to Ghanaians the unexpected and huge deployment of personnel in most of these cases because we are not sure we are in a police state. Further asking the IGP to cease the unwarranted prosecution of the aggrieved assembly members in Asin South for perpetually railing curses on people who deprive them of their right to vote and rather render an unqualified apology to them for the way they were handled. We are asking the Minister for Local Government, Rural Development and Decentralization to immediately set in motion a mechanism to repair the damaged relationship and cooperation between the assembly members of all these mentioned MMDAs and the would-be MMDCEs in order to foster unity, cooperation, and partnership for development in our districts. We are asking the local government service to organize a series of intensive workshops for all its staff in the MMDAs on good and responsible human relations and congenial working environment in order to repair the demoralized confidence of his staff who have been witnesses to all these disgraceful acts in the approval process. This will help improve their interaction with the players in assembly and enhance productivity. Finally, we wish to state that on resumption of the House, we shall help this August Parliament to look at the constitutional provision, the Act, and the model standing orders of the assemblies to streamline and strengthen the process and procedures for conducting assembly meetings, especially the special meeting called for such approvals to avoid characters and power-drunk dictators from abusing the democratic processes envisaged under our laws. Thank you very much. And for purposes of emphasis, we have video presentations of all the incidents in most of these places mentioned, voice notes, and we want to share them with you so that it will add to your narration when you are reporting.